Is Sal available to tell us what songs he asked George Takei to do?
Just take a remote mic in there.
He's in the bathroom shitting.
What like is he in the bathroom shitting?
Yeah, but that's like
same
10
time
minutes.
Every day.
He needs a colostomy.
He shits from 6:10 till 8.
So exactly. And it's so weird. I had to tell an intern. I felt so bad. I had to tell an intern to go over and tell him to hurry up.
Well, that's a job nobody should have. Do you know the songs, Richard?
I can give you the gist of it.
Yeah, go ahead.
He has the lyrics. It was a glory hole song.
And yeah, but I read the lyrics. They were really off the wall.
Yeah, I can't remember exactly what
Richard,
it was. But
does it cross your mind to check with anybody, or are you just guys?
Well, I think what we were thinking at the time is that George, to us, seems like such a part of the show.
Yeah, that's the problem to you guys.
He's a guest. He's a guest.
He's really
a guest. You should treat like if Tom Cruise is here.
All right, you know, I don't want to even make a mockery of the discussion I had with
well,
you guys.
Well, we're sorry.
I want you to take it seriously.
Oh, we are, definitely.
Because, yeah, I mean, I was at ground zero, like, ready to...
Where did you pull them in?
After the show, Sal, how many songs...
Look, here's a man who just finished something terrible.
Yeah, something gross just came out of him.
Sal, you got shit all over your shirt.
I gotta sit down.
Just because I'm talking about this on the air, I don't want you guys to think I'm not serious about this, because I am.
I know.
I mean, I really am.
You know, Howard, I had a prescription for Xanax for quite some time that I never filled.
Right.
And the morning Gary told me how angry you were, I actually took two Xanax that day. You gave us the private meeting. Because
what was the song you wrote? Well, how many other songs did George reject? I thought there were more than one.
He rejected Glory Hole to Jingle Bell Rock.
How did it go?
Glory hole, glory hole, push out your cocks. I'm on my knees and ready to suck. Black cock, white cock, Spanish or Jew. It doesn't matter because they all shoot goo.
So, I want to hear how Brad like told him no.
Well, we gave him the paperwork and he started reading and he goes
the paperwork.
He goes, you don't mind if I review this with Brad tonight, do you?
Yeah, because Brad's big balls had different lyrics and
I knew that
George and Brad changed them around.
That's the edited version.
Yeah. Well, what happened was George came in the next day and George goes, I talked to Brad and we need to make some changes. This is so crude.
Brad's big balls hanging in his underwear. When they're in my face, I'll take a taste and spit out the pubic hair. Brad's big balls smacking on my rear. Cause juicy nuts slapping on my butt makes me one happy queer.
Wow. What did he change?
Well,
that's okay.
Well, we don't really want to. We shouldn't say what he changed.
Oh, it was
Brad and him wasn't comfortable.
He goes,
but what was the song that you wrote?
Well, it was that.
Gary has the paperwork. Gary has the original lyric.
What was the original lyric?
Brad's big balls. Brad's big balls
bouncing on my chin.
Yeah. He treats me like a slut with his finger in my butt and shoots a load on my happy grin, something like that. So it was really, but when George came in to have us change the lyrics, we changed it to that.
Yeah.
And when he saw those lyrics, he goes, "You guys are lyrical doctors."
he thought you would never come up with anything.
He was so impressed.
He was impressed. Yeah.
We got the Tin Pan Alley over here.
We changed cock to dick. That's all we did.
You're no hacks.
He goes, "You have no class, but you're lyrical doctors."
Yeah, you're like Gilbert and Sullivan.
Yeah.
You too. Tin Pan Alley of pornographic songs.
You too should be in the Brill Building.
And you're right, he loves to sing. He's like, let me redo penis on White Penis.
He did about 10 takes.
Yeah.
You got the outtakes?
Yeah, a matter of fact, we have him reading the original lyrics.
Yeah.
And we do have it. We do have it in the back, right? Yeah.
Would it take forever?
Maybe there's a whole
No, it won't take forever.
Here.
We could cut it up pretty quick. Yeah. But we have him reading the original lyrics.
Dreaming of a white penis, just like the ones I used to blow, with a sweet pink glisten, even when it's hissing.
What?
It sends a tingle through my throat. I'm dreaming of a white penis, a curvy blue vein hard delight. I am gay and I'm horny, that's right. And I love one inside me Christmas night.
Well, we got Christmas in there anyway.
Sure. Jesus would be so proud.
Hey, Howard, there's a channel on Sirius that plays all Christmas music.
Just slip those in. You know, because that's all computer. We can probably...
Yeah. Oh, that would be great.
That. We can probably... Screw with that,
hack into it.
Right after the Christmas Waltz by Frank Sinatra.
Yeah, yeah.
We have white
like, like Beth has it on all the time because she has the Christmas tree up.
Yeah. And
like,
oh, and, I have it on all the time.
And
too.
It's a channel too, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
It's like she has it going 24/7. I feel like I'm in Saigon. You know?
Like, being tortured.
Yeah, it's like on every single minute with the wow. Christmas. It would just be really funny if all of a sudden it was.
Brad's big balls. Brad's big balls hanging in his underwear.
Why not?
How great would that be?
Spice it up a little.
Because kids listen to it, too.
So well, that would be the thing. If somebody is using this in their department store.
Right. I don't need that aggravation.
Would you love to hear Brad and him talking about what they're rejecting?
Yeah, that would be something to film.
What do you have on? What do you mean? You just have outtakes?
We have him reading the original Brad's Big Balls, just rehearsing it.
We the had original.
A, yeah, because...
With the original lyric.
Yeah, yeah. With the original lyric.
Could you just throw that right up
yeah,
now?
Yeah, yeah, we could cut that up.
Would it take forever?
Or? No, not at all.
All right, go ahead. Give me something to do. Two maniacs grabbing people in the halls. I said, it's not that it's not funny. It's just, I just want to make sure George is cool with it and let us handle that stuff. Just run it by Gary. Don't go off half-cocked, so to speak, you know? So... Yeah, I really do hope they understand because, you know, it could turn into a disaster.
Because this is what you do as a parent. First, you criticize them, and then you play it and praise them.
Right.
Yeah.
It gives us a mixed message.
That's the problem. Yeah, and I even wasn't...
And you're talking to two of the looniest guys. They I know. Can't figure this out.
And how do I not play it for you?
But I'm just saying, they can't figure you out because of this.
Yeah, I said to Gary, look... I'm going to talk to these guys off the air, and I'm livid. I said, this is it. You know, I love them, but they can't work here if they can't get the fucking thing straight. I said, it's fine. They wrote this. Just, you know, let me check with George first. Pull him in, blah, blah, blah. I get on the air on Monday, and then I say to you.
Now look at how much fun
and
we're having.
And then we're laughing at it.
Yeah.
You see, that's why I can't run a business.
You're fucked up, too.
I'm fucked up. Everyone's fucked up.
Well, yeah, what are you going to do?